Warning, the following story includes scary and possible gory elements that may scare some viewers. Children under the age of 13 cannot watch this video. People over the age of 13 can also watch this for its value and nostalgia to the original creepypasta the story is based off. Viewer restriction is advised.
There have been many stories about ghosts on railways. Some would be made just to give people a good scare. Others would be based off of true events that happened in the past. Whenever these one would be true, it's up to those who hear about it. But those who tell the stories would know the answer. One of these stories has been told many times, but all have different descriptions, all of which are false. This is how the story really went. It was the year 1913, and a designer named Lawson Billington on the London and Brighton and South Coast Railway has designed the first ever E2 tank engine. His name was Timothy. His number was 100, but some people numbered him 0 after the second E2 was built, since he was a prototype after all. Over time, more E2s were built, and the class was designed to work at the Brighton docks. However, the younger engines kept teasing Timothy for being out of date. Since he was the older version of his class, only a few engines didn't tease them. One of them was number 108, better known as Thomas. He and Timothy had become the best of brothers. However, in 1915, Thomas was sent to Sodor to work on the Northwestern Railway.
Well, Timothy, I guess this is goodbye. I hope we cross paths soon.
Don't worry, little brother. I'm sure we'll meet again someday. Just remember, you're a really useful engine. Show that fat director what you can do.
Thank you, brother.
Soon, another engine came to take Thomas to Sodor on a good stream of rails and sleepers for it to build the railway. As they left the harbor, Timothy began to get worried. Thomas was the only one of his brothers that wasn't being so rude. But with him gone, he knew that things would soon get worse. Years have gone by, and the railways of the United Kingdom were changing for the better. More bigger and powerful engines were being built. Trains were getting longer. Services were getting faster. Many of the older engines were showing their ages. Especially Timothy. He hadn't been to the works since the day he rolled out of the workshops. His parts were feeling worn, and he was needing an overhaul. But the railway couldn't afford to pay for the repairs due to their money going to making newer and more modern engines. But they did promise that they would make sure to get enough money to repair them soon. Whilst he waited, he was sent to handle light goods and passenger duties. The other E2s were starting to worry if Timothy would ever be repaired. However, the modern engines couldn't help but tease him about it. One in particular was the rudest of all. His name was Jeffrey. He was an experimental express mixed traffic engine. and was the only one of his class built. But since he was more versatile, he was given high praise for it. This would go to his smoke box and make him very conceited. He was rude to any engine older and outdated than he was, especially Timothy. One day, Timothy was resting in a siding next to the sheds. As he rested, Jeffrey puffed back into the sheds, two blue painters.
So, when will you two be heading to Sodor?
Tomorrow morning. That director needs an engine to pull the expressive course.
And he does need a heavy goods engine. We'll make sure to be the pride of the line. Right, Alfred?
Of course, Crowley. We will show those engines the pride of the GNR.
Well, at least you will be a better example of your line than that pile of scrap.
Jeffrey mentioned, looking over to Timothy and deciding.
What did you just call me?
What are you, old-timer? You being so old and worn out, I'm surprised you haven't fallen to pieces yet.
It's because the railway board knows that I'm still really useful. I just need some repairs and I'll be as good as new.
That is if you don't break down completely before them.
Quite right, Alfred. You look like you would fall apart before you reach 30 miles an hour.
At least I take pride in my work. You freezers boast on how more modern you are and start doing your work properly.
At least we're not rusting away like you. You're nothing more than a museum piece at this point, Timothy. Or you could just be sent off to be scrapped. I'm sure that would be the best solution.
Timothy let off steam angrily. Jeffrey was going too far this time.
At least my railway had the balls to build more of my class. You're the only one of yours in existence. If anyone should be on display, it's you.
Jeffrey, Albert, and Proven were in shock. Timothy said nothing as he left for his next train. Jeffrey was furious. He was sure Timothy was too old to be working anymore. He wanted to get back at Timothy for what he said, but he didn't know how. A few days later, Timothy was having a rest in the shed, when the shipmaster came running up.
Good news, old boy. The manager's finally managed to collect enough money to get you fully repaired.
Timothy smiled broadly. He had never felt so happy in ages.
Oh, thank you, sir. When will I be getting repaired?
They have arranged for you to go tomorrow. I have arranged a special passenger service for you to take this evening. After all your hard work over the years, me and the manager think you deserve it.
Timothy was excited, and all the other engines were glad about their pal finally getting fixed. All except Jeffrey. There was no point in having an old kettle like Timothy getting an overhaul, he thought. Then, Jeffrey had a very devious idea. If Timothy was getting an overhaul, then he was going to make the old engine damage beyond repair. He pulled out of the sheds and began plying his plan. That night, Timothy was taking his train. He was really enjoying himself. He was running right on time, and the driver and fireman were very pleased with how well they were running. But that was soon to change. Further up the line, Jeffrey was at a set of points. His driver seemed to be doing something to them. You see, one way went along the main line, and the other led to a bridge under construction. Soon, he had jammed the points. Just as Timothy's whistle was heard.
Quick, let's get out of here before he sees us.
The driver agreed and climbed back into his cab, and they raced off before they could be seen. Soon, Timothy approached the points. He had no idea that the points were switched down the wrong line and away from the main line. But neither Timothy nor his crew realized their mistake. They've gone too far up the line, when Timothy shouted,
"Brakes, driver! Brakes, quickly!"
The driver looked ahead to see the unfinished bridge further up the line. His driver slammed the brakes on hard, but they were so old and worn out that they were useless. The way the coaches didn't help either. The driver put the brakes on the coaches, and Timothy was still going too fast to stop in time. Timothy knew he wasn't going to make it, and quickly made a rash move.
Driver! Fireman! Jump clear!
But what about you and the passengers?
Just do it!
And that's what they did. The driver and fireman jumped clear, and Timothy shut his eyes tight. Then, everything happened at once. Silence fell. The driver and fireman got up to see if the coaches had stayed on the rails as their couplings snapped and the brakes were on full. So they stopped almost instantly. Timothy, however, had gone off the edge. As the fireman and guard looked after the passengers, the driver went to the nearest signal box to phone for help. They couldn't get the cranes to warn him. But by then, it was far too late. Timothy was damaged severely. Many parts were either broken or missing. His paintwork was completely ruined, and his face was completely gone. Timothy was dead. Everyone was downcasted from the news, and a memorial was held for Timothy for his actions that allowed his crew and passengers safe from the accident. Everyone was devastated. Not more so than a certain blue tank engine, who was practically in tears. But none of the engines didn't seem more guilty than Jeffrey. He never told the other engines what he'd done that night, or though he wished he did. Recently, he had been getting nightmares about Timothy's ghost returning for revenge. Even though they weren't real, little did he know that those nightmares were meant to act as a warning for what was to happen next. Jeffrey was resting in the shed. He was alone. Alfred and Krogan had gone to Sodor to work on the Northwestern Railway. And the other engines were away in the other shed across the network. As he was resting, however, the air began to go cold, and the mist began to thicken across the yard. Then, there was the sound of a steam engine puffing towards him. Jeffrey woke up to see that no one was there. He began to shiver down his boiler.
Who's there?
No one replied.
Alfred? Krogan? If you're playing a trick on me, it's not funny. Stop it!
Still no reply. Then Jeffrey could make out the sound of an engine puffing slowly towards him. Jeffrey began to grow concerned.
Hello?
Again, there was no reply. The engine stopped not too far away from Jeffrey. After a closer inspection of the engine, he soon knew who it was, and he got a massive shock when he realized.
No, impossible. This has to be another dream. This can't be real.
But Jeffrey wasn't dreaming this time. It was really him. Suddenly, the engine got closer to Jeffrey.
Stay back! I'm warning you!
The engine said nothing. He was close to his buffers. Jeffrey was mortified. He didn't know what to do. Then, after a moment of silence, the engine spoke.
No! No!
As he felt his body weaken, he was very soon silent and lifeless. The engine said nothing, and just looked at the remains of what was left of Jeffrey. His eyes bounced to the back of his smoke box as blood poured out of his eye sockets. Then, the engine started to laugh. The laugh got louder and louder. He was going insane with the power. And soon, after a long and devilish laugh, he reversed and faded away into the night. And now, every year on the date of the accident, it runs again as a warning to others, stealing the souls from the engines that mistreated him. Laughing maniacally, like a lost soul.
Thank you.